critical.
Look, Boyd, classified. Hey, what do I have on you here? Sensitive information to which access is restricted by law or regulation. How do you pick up the name, man?
I'm not gonna lie, I wish I had a good story for it. This is gonna be a slow one, but yeah, as a young kid, you know, doing the rap thing, and you know, as I came up, rappers always had their aliases or whatever, so I was always kind of bouncing back between names, and you know, when I was in the studio for the first time, I was like, I need something concrete, something that I feel like describes me. Went through the paper, said, next thing I see that jumps out at me, I see it came to the classified section. I was like, classified. You know what I mean? I'm a classy dude. You know what I mean? I find nowadays hip hop is so classified into different underground, commercial, whatever. Yes. I find my shit is very unclassified. You know what I mean?
Do you consider yourself now as an underground rapper?
Depends who you ask. For me, I don't see the whole underground commercial thing anymore. I used to be the same way. I used to be underground, you know what I mean? But
you were Sony BMG now.
Yeah, so technically, I guess I'm commercial.
Yeah.
But you know? Lyrically, musically, my shit ain't changed in 5 years. You know what I mean? I'm still on the same tip, still represent what I represent. Mm-hmm. And I still feel like I'm saying something that a lot of people aren't saying. So to me, that's underground.
The people that are going to be watching this video are in almost six or more countries. Radio Nigeria, Peace, World Star Hip Hop, all the guys up there. Q's my boy, but hey Q, what's up? I got this one for you. Canada, remember? And I also have people in the US and of course Canada, Canadian rap fans. Look, Boyd, known as Classified, is coming out with a new album. Tell us the name of the new album, when it's coming out.
New album's called Self-Explanatory, comes out April 7th. So this has been something I've been working on for like the last year and a half. You know, in between tours and stuff. And yeah, it's 22 minutes, I filled the whole CD. I'm trying to bring back the CD, you know what I mean? And so many people don't want to buy CDs no more, they buy the singles. But I wanted to make an album that was a full album, something that connected together. Like, you can't get the feel that you're going to get from the album without having the CD. So yeah, I'm excited. I hope people feel it.
What are the basic singles that we're pushing now?
Trouble's the first one we dropped, which is kind of like the animated street single. I just wanted to come something for the hate, you know what I mean, before. Next one's going to be called Anybody Listening.
That's a hot one. I heard that on Z103 Toronto.
I feel that
song.
People seem to be feeling it. So, you know what I mean? For me, that was something a little different. It was more upbeat, but at the same time, still bringing that, the lyrics that I bring. So, I'm hoping it's going to do great.
Classified interviewed a couple of days ago with Z103's Chris Evans. It's on hiphossip.com, HIPHOSSIP. Go listen to that interview. It's major. This guy's doing big things. Your albums in the past years, Time's Up Kid, One Shot, What Happened, Information, Now What, Touch of Class, Unpredictable, Union Dues, Trial and Error, Boycotting the Industry, Hitchhike Music. Striking names for your albums,
you know,
man.
Yeah. And honestly, that's how Self-Explanatory came, because I was going through my album names. And I'm like, I need a name that describes this album. Mm-hmm. And I was bouncing through so many things, and then I was like, this shit's Self-Explanatory. You listen to the album, you get it when you get out of the album, you know what I mean? And at the same time, Self-Explanatory. I'm explaining myself, you know what I mean? So it's...
I think it's great. This singles are great. You've been in the business for years, man.
Yeah, it's...
I think it's great. This singles are great. You've been in the business for years, man.
Yeah, I still feel like I got that hungry back in the day. You know what I mean? Because I came up on cats like Maestro, Chocolate, and cats like that who still do it. And like when I get in the studio with Maestro, he still has more energy and excitement to do music than most cats I know that are just coming up now. Like, you know, it's just like, hey, let's make this track, smoke some weed. Maestro's like, let's go through some records, let's dig, let's, you know, find the samples, and he's excited, and that shows me, like...
You hear that? You hear that? And that's why I created Hip Hossip for Canada. We have to recognize this Canadian artist. They're working hard.
Trying to do the thing.
Everybody out there, you better put some good comments on World Star Hip Hop. I want to see good ones over there, or else I'm going to get you, Kemi. But anyway, I always ask this from every rapper. Do you have a dream person you would like to collaborate with in the future? They might be watching.
There's a lot of cats, you know what I mean? I'd like to work with a lot of cats. I came up on like early 90s hip hop, you know what I mean? So a lot of cats from that era, a couple guys I got to work with, but if I had to pick like one person, it had to be Dre. You know what I mean? Like
Dr. Dre.
I think that's, you know, most cats.
Dr. Young is a good friend.
Really?
Dre, yeah, Dre,
I'm
man.
I don't know,
he was on. Andre just had a tragedy, one of his sons died.
I read about that, yeah, so it's,
you know, the Detox album, he had to stop everything. You know, they're doing these albums that are so, you know, when you hear the names of it, it sounds like art mimicking life, Detox, the kid died of an overdose, you know, all that stuff. He's producing Eminem's album, and that album, I think it's before I self-destruct or something like that.
No, it's 50s. Okay. It's called Relapse.
Relapse. Yeah. It all circles around drugs and all that.
Yes, and that's what I heard. They all kind of tied together. Yeah.
It tied together.
Before I self-destruct, relapse, and detox.
Tell me, what do you think about the drug culture?
The drug culture? I've never done hard drugs in my life. Same time, weed is weed. I don't think it's much different than alcohol, honestly. Mm-hmm. Then you get into harder drugs like, you know, heroin, crack, cocaine. To me, that's the stuff that has a long-term effect that affects people. It affects the person doing it, affects the family, affects a lot of different situations. So, I don't know, I don't play with that stuff, and that stuff's all around on tour. Like, when you're on tour, that is offered to me every night. And I just, you know, I made a promise to myself young, like, I'm not going to get into that. I seen the rock and roll movies and how these guys end up 20 years later. I ain't trying to be that guy.
Yeah, so. I know what you mean. I really, really appreciate this interview. Hip Hop Sip is HIPHOSSIP.com. Give us all your website, Half Life Records.
www.myspace.com/hiphopclassified. www.halfliferecords.ca. That's my own label with some artists that I work with and stuff. And then the Facebook group, Classified Facebook. So yeah, check it out, keep in touch. You know, we still do this on a grassroots basis. And you know, we reach out to the fans and talk to the cats. So get at us. What up, this is Classified with my girl Kemi, representing the best hip hop site in the world, hiphop.com. Y'all know what it is.
Y'all heard it.
More than a business, much more than a kid trying to get rich. Live this like it's an addiction. Spit this, whether anybody listens. I don't know if you're really hearing me, but these lyrics seem to be my therapy. Guaranteed, I hear the beat. My stress gets released till I feel the.